This video is going to be about working with positive and negative numbers. And I just want to go over the basic rules for what happens when you add or subtract or multiply or divide numbers that are positive or negative or mixed. So let's look at multiplication and division first. When you multiply two positive numbers, let's say you're multiplying 2 times 3, you're going to get a positive answer. If you multiply two negative numbers, so negative 2 times negative 3, you'll also get a positive answer. So the basic rule here is if the signs are the same, you get a positive answer. This is going to work for division also. So if I have a 10 and I'm dividing it by 5, well, 10 divided by 5 is 2. And if both the signs are negative, so negative 10 divided by negative 5, I also have a 2. Okay, so for multiplication and division, when the signs are the same, either both positive or both negative, you get a positive answer. When the signs are different, like 2 times negative 3, you're going to get a negative answer. It doesn't matter which of the signs is negative, that it could be the first one. So negative 2 times positive 3 is also going to give us a negative answer, a negative 6. So when the signs are different in multiplication, you end up with a negative as your answer. The same thing works for division. If I have negative 10 divided by 5, I'm going to get a negative 2. It doesn't matter which sign is negative, which is positive. So if I have a 10 divided by negative 5, that's also negative 2. Okay, so quickly once more, when the signs are the same for multiplication and division, your answers are positive. When the signs are different for multiplication and division, your answers are negative. Okay, let's go on to addition and subtraction. I'm going to try to look at all of this as addition, but let's get subtraction out of the way quickly just by dealing with one kind of problem. Let's say I have 5 minus a negative number, 5 minus negative 2. Okay, if you have a subtraction and then a negative, you can combine both of these minus signs into one positive sign. So 5 minus negative 2 is going to be the same as 5 plus 2, and of course that's going to be 7. Anything else we can just look at as a normal addition problem or combining two numbers. Let's just call it combining. Okay, so let's get some of these out of the way. If I have, once again, two positive numbers, like the 5 plus 2 that I just did, well, two positive numbers is going to give you a positive answer. You're combining two positive numbers, you get a positive answer. If you combine two negative numbers, so negative 2, negative 5 minus 2, you're going to get a negative answer. Two positive numbers, you get a positive. Two negative numbers, you get a negative. Now, let's take a look what happens when one is positive and one is negative. So let's say I have a negative 5 plus 2. Here's what you're going to do. Look at the numbers. Forget about the signs for a second. Look at the two numbers. Take the smaller number, which would be the 2, and subtract it from the bigger number. So 5 minus 2 is 3. And then in front of that number, put the sign of the bigger number. So the sign here is negative. We got a negative 5. I'm going to make this a negative answer. Which makes sense. If you're combining a lot of negative with a little bit of positive, you're going to end up with negative. What if we have, 5 minus 2? So I'm saying we're going to combine these two. You're probably thinking we're just subtracting. But basically, the same rule is going to work. I'm looking at the two numbers, the 5 and the 2. I'm going to subtract the smaller number, the 2, from the 5. I'm going to get a 3. Then I'm going to look at the sign of the bigger number, So the bigger number is 5, and it's plus 5. So this is going to be a positive answer, plus 3. Okay? So basically, when you're combining two numbers, if they're both positive, you're going to have a positive answer. If they're both negative, you're going to have a negative answer. And if you think about this, this makes sense. Obviously, adding two positive things is going to give you positive. If you add two debts, you're $5 in debt, and then you have $2 more in debt, you're going to be even more in debt. You're going to have $7 in debt, negative 7. So two negatives are going to give you a negative when you combine them. When your signs are different, just look at forget about the signs for a second, look at the number part. Subtract the smaller number from the bigger number. That's going to give you a number. And then see which of those two numbers which of those two was bigger, and use the sign for that number as the sign in your answer. Okay? So practice this. Get plenty of exercise so you can do this automatically and make sure it makes sense. And don't forget about the two negatives in a row adding up, becoming a positive. Okay? So that's it for now. Get plenty of practice. Take care. I'll see you later.